Hi, my name is Jason Morrell, and in this very short video, I'm going to walk you through a little trick to convert big long numbers into shortened versions. So for example, where you've got something like a million that has one with six zeros that follow it, it might make more sense for you to display that as 1M, 1 million. If you've got a number that goes into the thousands, so something like this, 57565, it sometimes makes more sense to display that as 57.6K. So the M and the K at the end of each number there are commonly used to represent thousands and millions. So how do you create these? You can't just select the numbers and go to your standard number formatting options here. These are too general. And even if you go to your format cells box and go to your number and currency options here, there's not enough depth here to get you to this point here. So what you need to do is to actually create a custom format here. So we have a list of numbers here that goes from a single digit right through to the multiple millions down the bottom there. And what we're going to do is to do a few examples of custom formatting using a mixture of the K and M suffix. So let me just copy this across to this second column, and we'll work on this second column here. So the first thing we do is to select the range, press Control 1, or you can right click and format cells. That displays the format cells box here. Come down to the custom option at the bottom, and in the type box, just wipe out whatever's there. So let's say, first of all, we want to show everything as millions. So whatever the number is with an M on the end. Now we might have to show a few decimal places here to get the smaller numbers showing up, but here's how we do it. So what you do is you create a custom format that says 0.00. Now that will show a whole number and two decimal places, whatever the number is, followed by two commas. Now what the two commas do is it says only show the detail down at the millions, okay, not the smaller units. What you then do is you put a backslash M, which represents millions. Now that's all we need to do there. And when we click OK, it shows everything here as millions. So really the smaller units don't really show up at this kind of level of detail. But you'll see down here we've got a 1.5 million there and a 15 million at the end there. If we'd have only done one decimal place or even just a whole number, then only these two numbers really would show up anything at all. So let's say you want to come down a unit and display everything as thousands. So let me just copy this range across again to the next column. And what I'll do here is I'll represent everything with a K on the end. So again, go back to my format cells box, go to the custom format here, go to the general box and remove what's there. And this time I'm going to say 0.000, and I've allowed three decimal places here just for a bit more detail on the number. You put a single comma to follow that, which represents the thousands. So only show the detail down to the thousands, no further. And then you put a K on the end to represent the thousands. And that's all we do. You click OK, and everything now is showing us thousands. So if you look at this example, we have 15,000, which is showing us 15.000K. Okay, next one is 150,000, and so on all the way down there. Now, when you get into the millions, obviously that's showing now 1,500,000 or 15,000,000 because the numbers there are so big. So what you could do if you wanted to is to mix these up. So any numbers into the millions show with an M suffix, and any numbers that go into the thousands show with a K suffix. And then maybe anything that's not up to 1,000, so anything that's below 1,000, just show it as the regular number. So let's do one final example where we copy these across to a fresh column. And let's manipulate these. Now what we need to do here is to introduce, and that is square brackets. Now what square brackets do in a custom format is they allow you to create conditional logic. So what you do inside square brackets is to put your test. So first up, I'm going to say anything greater than or equal to 1 million, close the square brackets. And that means that whatever follows next will only apply that format to any numbers over a million. So what we do is we say 0. Let's say one decimal place, comma, comma, and then backslash M to represent the millions. What we then do is to put a semicolon separator, and I'm going to introduce a second test for the thousands. That's also in square brackets, where I simply say greater than or equal to 1,000, close the square brackets, and that means whatever follows this bit only applies to those numbers greater than 1,000 if they haven't already been formatted by the millions. So then I say 0.0, comma, K. So that bit covers numbers in the thousands. I'm then going to put a final semicolon and put a format that covers any other number that hasn't been covered by the first two. So for that, I might just want to put 0.00. The zeros just represent mandatory digits, so always show a digit in that position for the number. So when we click OK then, you'll see that these three numbers here, which are below 1,000, just show it as per normal. These three numbers here, which are in the thousands, show with a K on the end. And these last two numbers, which are in the millions, show with M on the end. So that's a neat way to shorten your numbers. I hope that's been useful. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you want more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe and you'll be notified as soon as they're published.